falls on Clark in last year's national championship game.
She has more size and length.
Clark, you bet.
Right off the back, let's get to it. We're talking Iowa, Caitlin Clark versus LSU, Angel Reese, everybody else. This game was fire right off the bat. You could feel the energy. Everything was high octane, and I'm talking about till the end. But Caitlin Clark, she was just draining buckets a little bit too much. The Iowa team came in. We're talking teamwork to the core, and I felt like LSU, they were playing a little bit more individual basketball, when in this case, when you're in this Final Four situation, you gotta ball out. You gotta do a little more. That teamwork comes in, and with Caitlin Clark and the Iowa team, you saw a lot of teamwork, even if it was just Caitlin Clark draining those buckets. And now hip-hop been needing a little bit of Drake, J. Cole, and Kendrick Lamar and beef, but throughout all of this, a lot of people might be shocked to hear this because y'all know I love music, right? I wasn't too much of a Future fan leading into all of this. Future wasn't my dude. If I went to go listen to music, he always had songs I liked, but I never gravitated towards his, like, albums and everything, right? But then they drop Like That, the Drake disc, because you know Drake and J. Cole lately, they've been throwing some shots. Kendrick teamed up with Future and Metro Boomin to drop this classic, and then within 7 days, it's number one on Billboard, and they have the number two song. So having beef and diss tracks hit number one on Billboard, I'm liking this part of hip-hop. You don't really see this in other genres because they're not as in your face with it, but I like that competitive nature, you know? I'm hoping Drake respond. Like, he probably gonna do something real sus. You know, J. Cole might respond, but then he's gonna be Mr. Nice Guy Cole. And Kendrick and Future, the only ones out here being aggressive. And props to Future, this album is actually a classic. Probably one of the better albums I've heard in a long time, at least hip-hop albums, when it comes to throwing stacks in the club and stuff. You hear this, you just want to, like, pull out money you don't have and start throwing, right? So Future hitting me on that angle, I'm like, yo, I'm just at the spot where I'm like, all right, Future, I get you. This is it. This whole album's fire. But Like That hitting number one, a diss track at number one, let's do it. Now, a lot of people are saying that wrestling is back. And over the last couple weeks, it could be the WrestleMania buildup, but it does feel like wrestling is different, right? Across social media, the content, the way people are interacting with wrestling news, it feels like it's 2000 to 2005, that type of attitude era where things are just, oh, you know it's real, right? And it's not real, but you know shit is getting real, right? So check this out. Let's look at this clip of The Rock and Roman Reigns giving the beat down. And I'm telling you, you couldn't pay me to do this. You know, but Cody Rhodes and Seth Rollins was out here eating these whips. Look at this. What Kendrick said?
I still got PTSD.
With the bloodline. Boom. Somebody come up with a plan to take this from me now. That's what I want you to understand. This is a vice grip. You ain't ever gonna get it. Examples. This is what it looks like.